Hello everyone, this is Izzy with Team TC, and thank you so much for joining me for the first episode of Card of the Week. This week I will be discussing a card that didn't really get to see much meta play in the 2019 season. However, with rotation occurring soon and Unified Minds also being released soon, I think it's going to see a lot more meta play and potentially will even become a staple for every fire type deck out there in the meta. This card is Lysandre Prism Star. Lysandre reads, for each of your fire type Pokemon in play, put a card from your opponent's discard pile into their lost zone. Basically every single circumstance this card can be played in, it could be pretty devastating and will easily affect the game's outcome. Especially with fire type decks in the meta that utilize a decent amount of fire type Pokemon in play on the bench, such as Reshizard, Blacephalon, and Baby Blacephalon, this card can be an easy one of addition to allow for hyper aggression in either late game or early game, giving it a lot of versatility and use. Lysandre is also very useful against other fire type decks as well, since most decks in the current meta utilize the fact that they can simply discard fire energy using Ultra Balls or other search cards, just to get the energy back by using Fire Crystal. Or even with a Baby Blacephalon mirror match, you essentially lower the amount of damage they can do next turn by at least 50 damage, potentially even more depending on how many Pokemon you have in play, which is pretty crazy seeing as they go from Okos to Tukos to Threekos really quickly. However, I think the most devastating effect this card can have in a game is playing against the Mew and Mewtwo tag team deck. Now, Mew and Mewtwo's ability, Perfection, allows them to copy the attacks of any Pokemon in your discard pile or on your bench. This really gives the card a massive amount of versatility, seeing as you could simply discard a Stage 2 Pokemon and be able to use its attack the same turn, skipping the evolution chain completely and allowing you to save a turn or two. However, if these Stage 2 Pokemon aren't in your discard pile and are in the Lost Zone, Mewtwo's ability is not effective and it loses basically all of its versatility in this sense and is forced to use its standard attacks. Now moving on from Mew and Mewtwo, Lysandre is also incredibly dangerous to decks that utilize recycling energy, such as Greninja Zoroark, in which the strategy typically is to start off the game by discarding energy right off the bat. By placing some of this energy in their lost zone, suddenly they also use the ability to Oko, and it extends the time of the game by a decent amount since there's not as much energy in the discard pile for the Naga Nidels to reattach to themselves to add another 30 damage. Now moving on from Greninja Zoroark, another deck this could potentially be useful against is Pikachu Zekrom Tag Team, which utilizes Tapu Koko Prism Star in order to accelerate energy onto the board. Typically Pikachu players try to get the energy accelerated within the first turn, but the possibility of discarding that first two energy could possibly save a late game Tag Bolt from occurring, and Tag Bolt is essentially what the entire Pikachu deck is built about, so being able to stop that GX attack from occurring is massive in this match. Alrighty. Search-wise, with Tapu Lele GX rotating out this upcoming season, having one of supporters suddenly becomes not so consistent, making it not as good. However, there are item cards that you can utilize, such as Pokegear and Acrobike, which allows Lysandre Prism Star to become a little more viable for play to get those one-off hits. And even outside of items, Tag Team's Jirachi can always be utilized for its ability, Stellar Wish, to dig for trainer cards to pop off earlier mid-game. Which, I think mid-game would probably perhaps be the best use for Lysandre, because then you thwart all of their plans and they kind of have to reroute in the middle of their thinking. Okay, all in all, while Lysandre's use is decently limited, seeing as it's a Prism Star and is immediately put into the Lost Zone after use, it's very devastating and is very aggressive in play against most decks, removing accessibility to potentially up to 6 cards, which is a real game changer in Pokemon, seeing as prize cards can be a major effectance as well. Alright, we're all wrapped up here, and thank you once again for joining me this week, and I'll see you next week.